We'll jump into our VE tuning window here to do our pull in. Let's do Control L. See our plot window is generating. Let's go ahead and do our pull here. Go check this out. So it did 354. Really not much of a difference. Let's go ahead and save this. Yes, let's go here to do our VTEC pull 4. And let's evaluate this. So taking a look now, we've moved our VTEC point up to that 4200. Let's take a look at our dynograph real quick. Looking right here, we still see we need to shift it higher. It's better. It's not dipping as much, but we probably need to shift it up here to maybe 5,000. So we're going to go and try to move that up one more time here. We do see that we picked up here our blue line to our pink line. We see our torque curve picked up, and we see a very, very minor difference here from our blue to our pink in horsepower, only about 3 or 4 horsepower. So looking at our fuel curve, we can see that point where it was showing that it had that pretty large jump from going in here with VTEC off to VTEC on, we're seeing that we're only going here from 11.7, our target, to 11.9. So that is pretty much flat. We can see our pink and our yellow are pretty much on top of each other, and then the feedback here is doing next to nothing. So we don't have to do anything with our fuel tuning. We're good. Let's take a look at our knock control and see if it showed any signs of knock. And it did right here. That's too much timing. This is exactly what I was kind of looking for this whole time. We can see we set our knock floor here pretty tight, and we're overstepping it up top here. We can see that we're getting some expectation in our knock voltage, and it's going over our floor. So if we're actually looking here, cylinder 1 and 2 are showing it's pulling out some timing. And then we also see in the mid-range here that we're also showing some timing being pulled out. We can see right here it's showing a half degree, showing going in here with the orange, even 6 degrees, because we had a pretty large step here. Let's focus in this a little bit more. So we're seeing as it has pretty large steps or oversteps in the floor, it will go in and have a magnitude of spark timing pulled pretty quick. What we want to pay attention to here is when we're watching this, we're seeing that it does pull out some timing here. If it pulls out 6 degrees, 7 degrees, it returns it pretty quick. And if we kind of pan through, cylinder 2 is returning it back in. We might want to speed up the decay rate. Let's go here to wizards. Setup wizard. We want to go and return the ignition time a little bit faster. And let's go in down into our knock setup. And let's go into our, let's see here, our decay rate. So what we're going to do.